Welcome to ChemExpo YouTube channel. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the PhD application procedure in Germany. We have invited Dr. Suchismita Saha. Recently, she has completed her PhD degree from University of Siegen in Germany. She is going to introduce you each and every single point which is very, very important to fulfill your PhD application in Germany. Watch this video till the end and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, ChemExpo.
Hello, I am Suchismita and I am very, very, very glad to be present here. Today I would like to discuss about some points regarding the PhD applications in Germany for chemistry. First of all, I would like to thank Shumon for giving me the opportunity to discuss on this topic here with you. I have just completed my PhD in chemistry from Germany. So based on my knowledge and experiences, I would like to discuss few points regarding the PhD applications in Germany for chemistry. Well, the first and foremost question may arise, why Germany? Why we should apply for PhD in chemistry in Germany? Well, at first I would like to say, because the chemistry in Germany is really, really, really rich. It doesn't matter in which arena you want to pursue your PhD in chemistry, whether it is a physical organic chemistry, synthetic organic chemistry, theoretical chemistry, supramolecular chemistry, you will find plenty of very good research group in Germany, irrespective of the sub-area of the chemistry. The second point I would like to mention for the application of PhD in Germany, you don't need GRE and TOEFL. I completely understand during masters, you are already overloaded with classes. You also have to do the master projects and also you have to take preparations for NEET, GATE and so many other competitive exams. So you hardly get time to study English for GRE and TOEFL. And I think this is one of the best part for the application of PhD in Germany, that you don't need GRE and TOEFL. The third point I would like to mention, the shorter time to complete your PhD in Germany. If you are doing it in India or in USA, you need almost 6 years to complete your PhD. But most of the universities in Germany, you can complete your PhD within 4 years. But there are also few labs where it takes more time. So if you can complete your PhD in shorter time, then definitely you will get more time to do your postdoctoral studies. And not only that, if you also decide that you will go to industry after some time of your PhD and not to academia, then I think that 4 years of PhD is more than enough. And then I would like to mention also that the funding in Germany for research is really, really, really good. So if you are doing PhD in Germany, you need not to worry about the chemicals and solvents. And not only that, all the universities in Germany are already well equipped. That means you need not to send your sample for measurement to the other university. And also you need not to wait a long time for the measurement. And the next point I would like to mention, that you know about your PhD guide and also the PhD field before coming to Germany. So in USA, the scenario is little different. First, you are cracking the GRE and TOEFL, then you are getting selected by the universities, and then you are going to USA. And then also after spending almost a semester, you are getting confirmed by the professor under whom you will do your PhD. So here, before coming to Germany, you get to know under whom you will do, and you can directly start your PhD studies from the very beginning. And at last, and obviously not the least, I would like to mention here, the stipend or the salary for PhD in Germany is pretty good. And not only that, the working environment is really friendly. And also it will give you a good amount of professionalism. So it is always a balance between the friendliness and professionalism. The working hour in Germany is generally 10 hours starting from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. And also you are getting holidays on Saturday and Sundays. So you are not always working under a huge work pressure. And personally, I believe our efficiency increases when we are not working under pressure. So that is the very good advantages to pursue your PhD in Germany. So now coming to the application procedures, when you should start applying for the PhD applications. I believe that it is always better to start the PhD fresh. Freshmen, if you are completing your master's, you just take 1 or 2 months of gap for your vacation and then you can directly start your PhD. So the best time to start the PhD is September. So if you want to start your PhD in September 2021, then it is always better to start the applications in September 2020 or latest by October or November 2020. So it is always better to start the procedure a little earlier. And the second question is, how many applications you should do or you have to do to get a PhD position in Germany? I will say it is several, and also it depends. You have to do quite a many because each professors are already getting 100 and 100 of applications. So it is not always that you will get a positive reply, but be positive and keep on doing the applications. The next question is how to find the professor related to the field you want to do your PhD. So it is always better to read the literature on which field you want to pursue your PhD. So if you are reading the paper or the literature, then you are getting an idea who is working in this field. And also you are going to the cross references and references so you can collect the name of the professors who are working in this field and who are working in Germany. And if you want to do your PhD in the same field you are doing your master's, then it become a little easier because already you know which professors are working in this field and from where they are. And also you can get an idea from your lab seniors and also from the professors. So, and another thing you can do, you can just write down the universities in Germany. And you can go to the chemistry department of the universities and then you can go to the web pages of the research groups. And from there also you can get to know who is working on which field. So you just write it down, jot it down anywhere in computer or also in paper that these professors are working in this field from this university, so I can apply to them. So it will take a little time. You can just spend 30 minutes a day is more than enough if you start it a little earlier. Okay, now the next question is how your application should look like. As there is no such examination by which the professor is identifying you as a potential candidate for PhD, like NET or GATE type of examination or GRE or TOEFL type of examination. So your mail should look really, really attractive. The mail should talk for you. And not only the mail, the cover letter, the CV, and also the recommendation letters should really be strong. Okay, so first I will be talking about the mail and then we can discuss about the rest parts. So how your mail should look like. First of all, I would like to mention that never do a copy paste mail. And what I mean by the copy paste mail is never forward the same mail to the 10 and 20 professors. Each application mail should be unique. And also when you are addressing the professor in the mail, don't address in a very general way like dear sir or dear professor, respected sir, respected professor. No, never do this. Always be more specific and address him by name like dear professor Dr. XYZ or respected professor Dr. XYZ. Now coming to the first part of the mail, which will be more or less same or very similar to each of the applications, where you will introduce yourself, you will give a very brief introduction of yourself to the professor. So in the first para, I will just write, I am XYZ from India, from this university. Currently, I am pursuing my master's and I want to start a PhD or I want to apply for a PhD position under your guidance from this time. And also, I am doing my master project under these professors and in this field. Okay, now coming to the second para, that is the most important part of your mail. And this para should really be different for each of the applications. And you have to really spend a little time writing this para, and also you have to read a little bit on the field of the professor you are applying. So in this para, you will say why you want to do your PhD in this field, or why you are interested to work in this field, and also what experimental skills already you have to work in this field, and what you want to learn and what you want to do. So you have to just read a literature on this field. So this is already done in this field, so maybe we can go a little further, a little forward, and work this. And also I have these skills already, I know I have gained during my masters, so I can contribute in this field. And also when you are applying for PhD, nobody is expecting you to be a super expert in this field. So PhD is all about learning. So also show that you are motivated to learn from this field. And in the third para, what is again more general, so where you will show that your other skill rather than the chemistry, that your communication skills and also your writing skills, and then also you tell that I am waiting for your reply, and we can discuss further on this application anytime with you, and then you are thanking him or her, and then you are giving regards to him or her, and then you are closing the mail. Okay, and so what should be the attachment for the mail? You should attach the CV and also your motivation letter and or the covering letter. These two things are must. And one more thing, it is very important, that is the research summary. If you can make one page of summary of your master project, and if you also can attach it in the mail, that will be really good for your application. Then the professor get to know that you are working in this field, so you have already gained these skills. And but the cover letter and the CV is really important, and the, also the cover letter, you should give some, you should spend some time to write the cover letter. Okay, so next question may arise, is there any independent funding for the for doing PhD in Germany? Yes, there is one I am already aware of, that is DAAD. But for that also, first you have to talk to the professor from Germany, and he is really interested to take you as a PhD student. Then only you can write together the application for DAAD. Well, and at last, I would like to say how the professor is selecting the PhD candidates. As I said earlier, that there is no such direct examination, so they are selecting you based on your mail and CV. But it is not like that. To do PhD in Germany, you have to be 10 pointer. No, but it is always better if your grade point is more. So if you have the grade point more than 8, it is really good. And also the recommendation matters a lot. So from which professor you are taking recommendation from India? If the recommendation is really strong, then really you have a very good chance to get PhD. And also if you have publication during your masters, then obviously you will get preferences. But if you don't have, don't worry, because most of the PhD applicant, they don't have publication during masters. So I think that is enough for today. Maybe we can discuss in more specific matters regarding the PhD applications later. I would like to wish you all the very best for your applications, and I am pretty sure if you are applying in a proper way, you will definitely find a good PhD positions. All the very best. Okay, bye-bye. See you later in another day. Bye.